Glucocerebrosidase, Wikipedia audio. 10GS, 1Y7V, 2F61, 2J25, 2NSX, 2NT0, 2NT1, 2V3D, 2V3E, 2V3F, 2VT0, 2WCG, 2WKL, 2XWD, 2XWE, 3GXD, 3GXF, 3GXI, 3GXM, 3KE0, 3KEH, 3RIK, 3RIL. NM00117181, NM00117182, NM00107741, NM008094. Structure. NP00048, NP00100571, NP00100572, NP00116582, NP00116583. NP00107087 9, NP032120. Imiglucerase, Velaglucerase, Taliglucerase alpha. Beta glucocerebrosidase is an enzyme with glucosylceramidase activity that is needed to cleave, by hydrolysis, the beta glucosidic linkage of the chemical glucocerebroside, an intermediate in glycolipid metabolism that is abundant in cell membranes. It is localized in the lysosome, where it remains associated with the lysosomal membrane. Beta-glucocerebrosidase is 497 amino acids in length and has a molecular weight of 59,700 daltons. Beta-glucocerebrosidase is a member of the glycoside hydrolase family 30 and consists of three distinct domains. Three-dimensional pi-mole rendering of glucocerebrosidase with three domains highlighted. Three-dimensional pi-mole rendering of glucocerebrosidase with catalytic residues highlighted. Domain I forms a three-stranded anti-parallel beta sheet. This domain contains two disulfide bridges that are necessary for correct folding, as well as a glycosylated residue that is required for catalytic activity in vivo. Domain 2 consists of two beta sheets that resemble an immunoglobulin fold. Domain 3 is homologous to a TIM barrel and is a highly conserved domain among glycoside hydrolases. Domain 3 harbors the active site, which binds the substrate glucocerebroside in close proximity to the catalytic residues E340 and E235. Domains I and III are tightly associated, while domains II and III are joined by a disordered linker. Crystal structures indicate that beta-glucocerebrosidase binds the glucose moiety and adjacent O-glycosidic bond of glucocerebroside. The two aliphatic chains of glucocerebroside may remain associated with the lysosomal bilayer or interact with the activating protein sapocin C. Consistent with other glycoside hydrolyses, the mechanism of glucocerebroside hydrolysis by beta-glucocerebrosidase involves acid/base catalysis by two glutamic acid residues and precedes through a two-step mechanism. In the first step, E340 performs a nucleophilic attack at the carbon of the O-glycosidic linkage to displace the sphingosine moiety, which is simultaneously protonated by E235 as it is released from the active site. In the second step, glucose is hydrolyzed from the E340 residue to regenerate the active enzyme. Mechanism. Beta-glucocerebrosidase is maximally active at pH 5.5, the pH of the lysosomal compartment. Within the lysosome, G-case remains associated with the membrane, where it binds and degrades its substrate glucocerebroside. GCase requires the activating protein sapocin C as well as negatively charged lipids for maximal catalytic activity. The role of sapocin C is not known, however, it is shown to bind both the lysosomal membrane and the lipid moieties of Glucker, and therefore may recruit Glucker to the active site of the enzyme. Beta-glucocerebrosidase is specifically and irreversibly inhibited by the glucose analog conduritol B epoxide. Conduritol B epoxide binds to the GCase active site, where the enzyme cleaves its epoxide ring, forming a permanent covalent bond between the enzyme and the inhibitor. GCase is the one of the few lysosomal enzymes that does not follow the mannose-6-phosphate pathway for trafficking to the lysosome. It is thought to be transported to the lysosome directly from the endoplasmic reticulum after binding the lysosomal transporter and integral membrane protein LIMPE. Mutations in the glucocerebrosidase gene cause Gaucher's disease, a lysosomal storage disease characterized by an accumulation of glucocerebrosides in macrophages that infiltrate many vital organs. Mutations in the glucocerebrosidase gene are also associated with Parkinson's disease. A related pseudogene is approximately 12 kb downstream of this gene on chromosome 1. Alternative splicing results in multiple transcript variants encoding the same protein. Alglucerase was a version of glucocerebrosidase that was harvested from human placental tissue and then modified with enzymes. It was approved by the FDA in 1991 and has been withdrawn from the market due to the approval of similar drugs made with recombinant DNA technology instead of being harvested from tissue, drugs made recombinantly, since there is no concern about diseases being transmitted from the tissue used in harvesting, and are less expensive to manufacture. Properties. Clinical significance. Recombinant glucocerebrosidase is used as drugs include drugs.